All right, well, let's leave it there at that, and see who's going to be upset after the end of the first game, because we're going into the draft for our match between Empire and Ninjas in Pyjamas. So here we are. We've already got our first bands out. It's going to be Queen of Pain versus Wisp. This draft couldn't have come sooner. Thank you very much, players, for readying up, and I'm sure they won't be pausing anytime soon. What are we expecting to see after the first bands? And don't say picks, because that's a douche thing to say.
Well, I mean, that's the obvious thing, right?
Thank you.
All right, so I don't know how highly Ninjas in Pyjamas favor Ember.
Or Brute.
Pretty high.
Pretty high, yeah. So I think Ember might be on the table for them here. I know Empire don't pick Ember nearly as much. Definitely not a silent hero, in my opinion.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm wondering if Nip has some Ember in mind for this game.
You're saying first pick Ember, Spur?
I think it's more likely to just be like support. Like a support hero, and then I think Ember is actually first to pick worthy.
Darkseer is good.
Darkseer is amazing.
Yeah. I think good lane pressure.
Kinda open. Do you think it's like takes away the Brood option for Empire with the Darkseer? Because he's quite good against Brood, right?
He didn't get the much of
it's not that good.
I'm more concerned about when you play Darkseer in the mid and late game, because when you end up with a certain composition of heroes, it just stops working in team fights when the Darkseer has, for example, the Blink or the BKB, can definitely get off a good vacuum walk.
Yeah.
So what heroes do you consider that you would play as cores against a Darkseer that you would be like, if it goes late game, we're not going to lose to a vacuum wall. You know, we actually feel pretty good about this. Or is it just you don't want to get into that stage?
I think if you get a BKB cores, and you can't get vacuum.
Shadow Fiend is great, I think.
Yeah.
Because you can just actually BKB Rec Room after a wall, and it destroys all the illusions.
Yeah, that's pretty good. True.
Yeah, we saw that in one of the games before.
Yeah.
Didn't we?
I think it's happened maybe once in the history of that.
No. But there was a game in particular that I can't remember like who was playing, but it was like BKB Requiem. All the images just died instantly.
Yeah, I remember
it's possible. It's a feasible story, Andy. We believe you.
It was actually a really solid counter. But I think Darkseer is not often as much about the wombo combo as it is just like how much you get from the lane. Like, it's very hard to stop this hero from getting something done. And he's also a natural mech carrier, which means you have a lot of flexibility with your other lanes, too.
But the thing is, whenever you have a Darkseer, I feel now, sure, the countering the lane's huge, but the Darkseer will normally always get to a point of just scariness. And even if it's later in the game, the wall being, like, what, 45 seconds now?
Yeah.
Base defense, it helps massively. So you have to, it's always that factor. Come on, Darkseer has to be that factor of, like, you're not playing around, you're not thinking about the... If you don't think about the vacuum wall combo in potential team fights, you can pick a lineup that's focused on the laning phase that actually doesn't work very well versus a Darkseer. And I've seen games where I've literally been like, okay, I've seen Sing Sing play, actually, as Darkseer, and I was just like, as soon as Sing Sing picks up his BKB after his blink, every team fight is over. And every team fight since he picked up his, got those items, because of the composition, not just because of Darkseer, the composition he was playing against, they won every team fight as soon as that happened. And before it wasn't, an easy win. So, yeah. Okay. Sorry, I'm just ranting. Just ranting. Try to chip in, guys. All right?
Yeah, it's good.
I haven't been on camera for a long time. Give us a break.
I like the Slaughter ban from Nip as well. Obviously, the minus armor stride with Dazzle Slaughter gets taken away. It's good. Winter Wyvern would have been really good for Nip, right? The vacuum into the frozen
orb curse. Yes, that combination is very powerful.
Yeah, it's overly bannable out. I've seen it in pub games.
I think the thing about Darkseer as well opens up a lot of melee cores as well, like Legion Commander, which I know Ninjas in Pyjamas like a lot. Even having Clockwork, like someone can just put the Ion Shell on and he can get right up and close to them. Like that's like huge. In
that's a pretty old school like dual lane, right? The Darkseer Clockwork.
It's very old.
I mean, it was run in the Dream League once. Or was it the qualifiers?
I think
the
major it's less qualifiers. Because both of those heroes kind of want farm at the same time.
Yeah, but what they did was they sent the Darkseer in the beginning in the jungle, and then he got level 3 in the jungle, and came down with Clockwork, and Clockwork was like level 2, 3 as well. And then they just took over the lane with Iron Shell. If they got someone in the cogs, he was dead. Like,
when you have a Darkseer and Shadow Fiend on the same team as well, it kind of allows Shadow Fiend to go like more late game items faster, like maybe even an earlier BKP.
Yeah, because he doesn't have to get the mechanism.
Yeah, so it also makes your other lanes a bit easier as well. You can maybe pick someone who doesn't have to be like super late game in your core position.
I think these are absolutely fantastic heroes versus the Darkseer, by the way, and the Shadow Fiend that they picked up for Team Empire. Dazzle is just really, really strong, because you shouldn't ever catch a Dazzle out of position. And as I've mentioned before, Dazzle, I'm not sure, I'm sure Nahaz, you know, someone like that would have stats who ever comes prepared for a show, but not like me. It's probably been doing fantastically in competitive Dota. And then Gyrocopter, just being able to clean up the illusions, you know, you always get a BKB, which just means, okay, you can negate a lot of the damage and you can fight through it. And if you've got your life still, as you can see, the Helm of the Dominator, you know, you're not that scared. So I think that core and that support, you know, for me, you know, really affects the Darkseer. The Witch Doctor is going to be picked up for the Ninjas in Pajamas. It's nice. I mean, how do you guys, you know, enjoy Witch Doctor these days? We saw it last game and it was great in the first match that we did get to cover, but
it's really good against Tusk, right? Like that's the main thing I feel. It's like you snowball in, you put a couple of heroes in there, a cast comes out, you can turn the fight very easily. I think that's always going to be a go-to. But I think this is more of a band-aid for another problem, because for now, I think that Gyrocopter was picked from Team Empire as more of a takeaway from Nip to not give them like the Darkseer and then the Gyrocopter together. But I don't know if Gyrocopter is actually that great of a matchup, because traditionally Shadow Fiend is seen as a counter to Gyro, because you do so much single target physical damage and you're a natural mech carrier, and they already even have one with a Darkseer too, so you actually have more freedom with your item build this game. But I feel that SF can deal with Gyro quite easily, and because they also haven't picked their own safe laner, it also gives them the advantage in the fact that they've seen like almost the completion of an entire lane only with three picks into the draft, right? So I think that actually gives Nip a slight edge, unless they're feeling very comfortable with their mid matchup.
Ooh, I like this.
This is actually really cool. Good.
The Ice Path Vacuum combo is really strong. And then potentially Shadow Fiend gets a Blink and like Blink in Requiem with that Wombo combo as well.
What do you think of a hero like Slark for Ninjas and Pajamas? Like, remove the refraction charges.
Slark is really good. I also think Blink is very nice as well.
Because
there's no like Winter Wyvern. There is a Grave, but at some point in the game, if the Klinks gets ahead, I think he actually like massacres these heroes.
Like I think you just get BKB on Team Empire's heroes, which you will get, and you'll win. And as long as you stack Ancients for TA, or even the Gyro, I think BKBs will end up winning this game a lot more.
They are playing Radiant TA, though. It's not as easy to stack Ancients yourself, right?
No, I would much rather play Radiant.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Radiant's closer to stack.
But you not think that's a factor, to a BKB on the TA and Gyro in this situation?
No, it definitely is. Yeah, like, you're always going to have item timings where those types of cores that can deal a lot of damage without not many damage items, it's going to be strong. Like, there's no doubt about that. But I just feel like Nip had the ability to win the game in like 20 to 25 minutes with their heroes. Like Chikiro with Liquid Fire, great for pushing.
That's true.
You have Shadow Fiend, Darkseer, strong lane.
And you have Witch Doctor healing as well to back you up.
So it's going to be similar to the first game of Force Sail Alliance. Like,
but this is what you said about Ninjas in Pajamas. They like to fight and be push and win the game on the earlier stage. And we said the Team Empire.
Control.
You know, but I feel that Empire probably, I mean, Dazzle's a good amount of sustain. TA and Gyro are going to be great, but not until they get their BKBs if it comes down to those tier 2 fights. What hero would you recommend that they pick up to help them fight?
Centaur or Axe, like some sort of strong, strong
for Empire.
Yeah,
I think that's a really interesting way to approach it. And then definitely, I would go with like Centaur. I'd be very happy with Centaur.
You can just run away from the Witch Doctor Lord and run with Mara.
Yeah? What if they did a Bamboo play and got like tiny offlane?
I don't think they play that.
I mean, yeah, obviously.
What if they were just jerks and picked up Klinks?
For the offlane?
Spirit Breaker. Spirit Breaker is actually kind
of something to break up the fight.
Yeah, it's awesome.
I like it. It screws with Shadow Fiend.
Not too sure about Spirit Breaker, because it feels like it has to make an impact on the laning phase, and it's very hard to make an impact against their support heroes and their cores, right? Jakiro has so much HP.
I think Klinks is amazing.
Witch Doctor can still sustain. Darkseer doesn't drop and can also surge away. I think the Spirit Breaker pick is not that good of a pick at all. I'm just going to say it right now. I should be playing for Team Empire. I should be the new captain.
I just feel like it's a pick that's only meant to be disruptive during the laning phase.
But that's the thing. I don't think it can be that disruptive during the laning phase.
But even if it keeps the two supports in one spot, I think that's enough.
Well, the thing is, their supports don't need items.
Yeah, but it's not about that. It's about the 1v1 for SFTA, because TA wins that matchup, right? And then Gyrocopter gets farm, hits 6, starts teleporting to fight with a charge on top of that. The thing is, other than Snowball, they had no reliable way of starting a team fight, and I think that's kind of why they needed the Spirit Breaker. Like, maybe they can go back for something like Clockwork instead.
I think Centaur would have been a way better
pick. Centaur was also really cool, but they needed a hard form of initiation outside of just Tusk, and I think that's why they went with SB.
I think someone like Slark or Legion Commander is very good for Ninja Gems.
Nip have played LC in the past, right?
Yeah, they're really okay. But they usually play it on Yawnus.
Well, you've got to worry about armor as well on your team a little bit. You're going to have a mech. You don't
Sven could work.
You don't have a great Vlad carrier in terms of, you know, until really late game.
I think they want a ranged hero. Okay, they're going to go Sven.
Shane, you're on it.
Yeah.
It's like I was leading you, isn't it? You know what I mean? Like a duo. Yeah.
We're good.
You know, I said armor, you say Sven.
I mean, Sven makes sense, right? Because like flag cannon, more armor against Dazzle, Weave, and Templar Assassin Meld, the Warcry is going to do massive work, right?
I think he's just going to get kited. Yeah, I think that's the problem.
That's you have the Surge. That's why it's good.
Sure, yeah, they have Surge. Just get Link, they have the vacuum into Stormbolt, right?
But even through BKB, they have a lot of lockdown. They have Sigil.
Yep.
They have TA, who Sven is not very good against.
Yep. So, quick predictions. You were all wrong last time, by the way.
Yeah, we were.
Skris said 1-1, but he was the closest.
Still wrong.
Yeah, still wrong. 50%
right.
He was
first wrong.
50% right.
No, it doesn't work like that.
You're wrong. Sure. It's fine.
Go on, prediction.
Hot sauce.
All right. I'm going to actually give Nip this one. I'm going to say they should be able to win.
I like Nip as well.
I think, though, if Empire get a good lead, they will destroy them. They'll walk all over them. TA can just eat them all alive.
It's not ifs or buts. What is it?
I'm going to go with Empire just to disagree with them and make a bit of tension.
Wow.
Is this game 1-1? Or do we just predict
this
game? No,
it's just this game.
Would you like to kind of smack talk them maybe and say why and they're wrong?
You got to... Okay, I'll switch. I'll go Empire. You can go Nip. Because that way... Because you wanted the Sven pick, right?
You know, guys are not taking predictions seriously here.
No,
okay,
now,
you can't just switch.
Now we can actually...
Okay, go.
Yeah, the trash talk is like, that's Sven. He's going to get kited. It's a terrible pick.
Dude, I'm going to Surge your Sven. He's going to have an Iron Shell on. He's going to run at your TA. He's going to destroy it.
0%. You're going to go hit a TA with Refraction on?
He's going to have an Iron Shell.
He's
going to
get
wrecked. All right, worst acting ever. Let's go into the game. Game one. I know. Empire versus Ninjas in Pajamas. I remember what I do it here. All right, welcome back. What a camera shot. Check out my shoes. We're going to go in-game. They've just started. I'm going to join. Going to have a little quadcast. I'll try not to talk too much. You are welcome.
That'll be very difficult for you.
Monkey
banana.
It can't be monkey banana.
We foresaw this monkey coming into the game, by the way, me and James. With our tactics.
Monkey?
Yeah, monkey banana. Come on.
All right.
Right, James?
Yeah, the monkey banana combo is legit.
No, but like I think Shane brought up a good point. Like, sure, the kiting and whatnot with Sigil traps and stuff, but Sven with Surge and the Iron Shell, also vacuum into Stormbolt, into Ice Path. Like, they have multiple ways to combo the vacuum.
Yeah, they got big combo. That's true.
I think it's like not too hard to execute what Nip has.
I think Nip, if I'm going to join and do a prediction,
sure.
I think the Spirit Breaker ruined the lineup for Empire. And I
you think it's that bad?
It.
Yeah, I really do.
I don't think it's that bad, James.
See what it does.
Yeah, sure.
Who's playing it?
Resolution.
Ah, okay. Well, it might be okay then. I think...
What a flip-flopper.
But I think let's still lose, because it won't be that good. It won't be as good.
Hey, what is this Sentry? Just to block, the engines for TA. Yeah, but straight away? That's... Okay. Interesting. How long does the sentry last nowadays? 2 minutes? Three?
Sentry, four.
Four? Three,
yeah,
four?
I think.
Is it 4 minutes?
I think a sentry is four minutes.
We saw it.
Yeah.
Thank you, Webus.
Thanks, Webus, for confirming. I am the master race.
There's just no one else plays support but you.
It's actually true. You're all jerks.
I mean, I play support, but I don't play sentries.
That's
unfortunate.
These guys are so confused. Look, that Tusk kid thought that Spirit Breaker was on the opposing team.
What an amateur move.
Empire, get your shit together.
Does he learn Dual Breath? Yeah, he has,
This is like the Jukes. Damn. Where did those refraction charges go, Andy?
Andy, you're right.
Dude, he doesn't have his BKB. Just wait. He's gonna go BKB.
He needs
first.
Like
no boots.
Really? So you just have to wait. That's a blink before BKB or something.
BKB?
Oh, he should get
liquid fire to catch.
I mean, he should get a BKB by like third, fourth creep wave, right?
Look at this refraction gun.
It's looking like.
No, but that's okay because top lane is gonna own now because they got two people mid.
Top lane's actually pretty scary. Spirit Breaker Tusk is a very scary lane.
That is true.
Not when you have a Witch Doctor. That makes bouncy
what's going
bounces.
On their safe lane? Gyro against Darkseer. Who wins?
Darkseer
wins, yeah.
Yeah, every time.
100% of the time?
Do you
time?
Really want to dive a Sven, by the way, with Tusk Spirit Breaker when you've got a Witch Doctor sat behind?
No, you go for the Witch Doctor, you don't go for Sven.
You'll never get to the Witch Doctor.
Yeah, you will.
Never.
Maybe you won't.
Intimidating words.
Ooh, pull in.
Yeah, Empire's biggest issue is they don't have good ways of starting fights. That's the big problem.
They have the shards, I guess.
Yeah, that's...
George.
Oh,
he might be dead. He's very tanky.
He's gonna live for like
Sven's
another
coming, though. Body
on the body blocks. Oh my goodness.
He's gonna live for 4 more seconds in
there's
shorter
the
way, right?
No, no, Sven's in...
Oh, no.
He got it!
From downtown. Is it issue? I miss Andy.
Yeah, no. Apparently you can make it work, I just... I'm lazy.
No. Okay, Shadow Fiend doing pretty good in the middle. 12 left.
He's literally right. One CS ahead.
What do you think of this, right? Darkseer goes Crimson Guard, and the Shadow Fiend still goes Mech. And they have the Crimson Guard for the Flak Cannon TA.
Yeah, it could be.
Yeah. It's not a bad idea, Shane. I like the way you think.
Just become the super tank.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Crimson Guard plus armor from Warcry. Mech. Could be.
Get a Vlad's on someone.
Did why is Vlad's on that team?
Jakiro?
Yeah, I guess.
But he wants like a Yule first?
Yeah,
Yule's in...
But do you favor Yules on that hero over Aghanim's on Witch Doctor?
Against Spirit Breaker? I think so.
Yeah.
Like, you could argue that Nip kinda also lack initiation.
Okay, so they moved the Dazzle down on the bot lane now. As you can see on the minimap, the Darkseer is still getting what he wants. I don't know, do you
is that
think...
a fight top? No, sorry.
No, it's fine.
Just testing weapons.
Yeah, just testing your weapons.
Weapons, guys. Don't that weapons.
I love the way you're like homies now. Observer homies.
Yeah, dude.
You're like a bond.
Yeah.
Oh, we watch together.
Still kid might be in a spot of
honor. Oh, he wasted it.
Now he's gonna...
Oh, the armor, though. The armor will do...
No, he's dead.
Where's the Stormhammer?
Wasting the,
There's the Warcry. Didn't have that mango up. Oh, mango cooldown.
Oh, yeah.
No, I'm kidding. There's no mango cooldown. They'll still get a kill, though. Resolution.
Yeah, jerk.
You need to run.
Oh, he mangoed.
He mangoed.
Does he have the shard block?
Oh,
he
getting...
wants to snowball out, I guess.
What the heck?
What is... Okay,
he's very tanky.
On? This is so
he didn't
not
have snowball.
He gets threats on Sven as well. That's big. Wait, what? Did he interrupt it?
He did it twice.
What's up? Okay.
Yeah, he's fine.
Yeah, he's actually
walk fine. It off.
Well, they get a kill.
Look at the haste rune.
Nice.
No. Okay. It's fine. It's fine.
That was really weird. I think what the Tusk was trying to do was go for the healing salve snowball.
Yeah.
Because he had a salve in his inventory and he could have potentially bought enough time to make
his snowball. Yeah, was on cooldown though.
But he
seconds.
Also could have tangoed, and his ice shards were like way off.
Yeah. That is true.
He could have just trapped the Sven and. Maybe try to kill him that way, but who knows?
This is our first pause for the toilet break.
Awkward time to disconnect.
Standard.
There's no fear of boots.
Oh. And if a commissioner of Dota 2 Esports.
Standard.
I'm slouching.
I have like the mega slouch going on right now.
Yeah.
The gamer slouch.
It's nice. I like Super Saturday. It's quite chill.
Yeah.
It's more super chill. That's the thing.
Mm.
It was in small text below the name, you just didn't see it.
Read the fine print.
Well, he's back in the game.
We're back on camera.
Look at how slouched I am.
He's in a very bad position, though.
Oh, yeah, he's probably been...
He doesn't have
spots.
A teleportation,
back to game
so he has a grave.
Ooh. Okay. He's got a gyro. He's Gucci.
No Ravage cast.
The body block.
The salve.
Oh, they kill Hanskin instead.
He has a salve, too.
Yeah, but...
Okay. He shouldn't have listened to me.
This is good though.
Oh,
we're
he's dead.
Yeah.
The lower dance will get a kill here. Almost get the Witch Doctor.
He is
here. He's gonna potentially die.
Tread switch and stun.
Nice
shorts. They can chase. They can chase. They can block him.
Yeah, it's worth going. He's got an Orb of Venom. No?
They have shards in two.
Yeah, you should be dead.
Boom. Off the bash.
Slam.
Alright, so
the fact that this lane is working, by the way, I am absolutely dumbfounded by
this lane is so
scary. Time on the stuns.
Yep.
That is why they're winning.
Yeah.
No, sorry,
snowball.
They have no instant stuns. They can dodge them with the snowball.
Yeah.
But they have two.
It's only one snowball.
They're obviously not timing the task snowball cooldown. Which
well, they knew that Sven was out of mana, so it's
yeah,
like,
yeah.
It's only one cask they can throw. They can
That's
throw.
Right. They can afford to do this.
Yeah,
NIP. Spirit Breaker will still be useless.
I like the fact that he actually saved his mango, because it's like a small thing, right?
Oh,
oh boy.
This is why you want Rocket.
Here. Rocket Same. Wouldn't catch that, come on.
Rocket catches everything. Scriff.
It hits 88 miles an hour.
Well, then you might see some sick shit. But before it hits that...
It is kind of crap.
No, it's not. Rocket is the
it
best.
It costs so much mana.
Are you trying to like plug Rocket League or something right now? Is that the
no,
thing?
No. Why would I do that?
I don't know.
Have you even played that game?
Yeah, a few times.
It's pretty fun.
It is fun.
DD on Limp now.
Do you have any stacks for the Shadow Fiend on Limp?
Yeah, they do.
Okay, looking good. Does Joker have any stacks? No, no ancient stacks. No normal stacks. How's your TA looking, Andy?
Oh, that's fine.
Look how tanky Spirit Breaker is.
What a hero.
He just walked into that. What a...
Oh, oink.
Noobs seem to be everywhere.
Oh, he's fine.
Yeah, he's dead.
And they even bottle him a bit.
Oh, he kills the trap.
What a pain. He's okay. He can move.
Oh my god, that side blade hit the Witch Doctor.
They're gonna go.
That's him, dude. Is he gonna get his man?
The cast.
Get his man!
Oh.
Outplayed.
Oh, Resolution just wasted this charge as well.
Yeah, there's no stun though.
This cow's are stupid.
Is coming up soon.
No. Just go back to farming, boys.
Oh, he's getting annoying.
Yep.
I think you need to go for a mech on Shadow Fiend. Or how's Darkseer doing?
Darkseer is doing
really well on Lasset.
Yeah.
What is he, does he have hand in the courier?
No, he went Arcane Boots first, which is fine.
He doesn't have a TP.
Doesn't have a vacuum though.
Oh.
He does have a TP.
He just baited it, I guess.
Hello? Wall?
Boom. Not level 6. He's dead.
Oh. That's not the wall.
It was almost the wall.
If he has someone with him, that's a really good play, but not having anybody with him, it's like throwing the wall, it's like you cannot expect to get anything from it. And not having vision on the Dazzle, it makes it impossible to chase. Yep. I mean, the effectiveness so far of the Spirit Breaker and Tusk has really been on Nip's lack of decision-making on these small team fights.
I think it's because they, like in the top lane at least, they had to commit so many spells just to be able to deal damage that they're just running low on mana all the time. And it's not
that's
as if Wand is particularly good against Spirit Breaker Tusk. Because Tusk only has two spells at the start and Spirit Breaker's got one. So you're not really getting much return.
Also,
that.
Yeah, Sven doesn't do much apart from the stun. Like he hits for 86. But...
And he's not even maxing his stun.
Yeah.
Which I actually think in this game is a mistake.
I would agree.
Against those tanky offlaners, like you need to max stun. You need to try to bait out a snowball and then stun. And use that damage to kill. Because your right click damage is non-existent at this point.
Especially with like Spirit Breaker, who starts off with so much armor.
Yeah,
it's 5, isn't it? 5
yeah.
starting armor.
I think it's 5. Yeah.
Spirit
Breaker used to be 6 and got nerfed,
six,
I think.
On level 5.
Yeah, he got taken down to 5 armor.
He's still so tanky.
Yeah, he's insane.
Isn't he like the biggest strength gain or something?
Spirit Breaker, no.
No.
Biggest strength gain is Centaur, I believe.
Yeah.
Starting strength, the Treant, I believe. Yeah.
Starting strength is him and then Spear Breaker, I believe. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Doom might be up there too.
Doom is like third. I used to know this all off by heart, and they kept on changing them.
Yeah.
Isn't Shadow Shaman like really good strength gain now?
Shadow Shaman?
Yeah, they buffed it.
Did they?
I remember, yeah.
I don't remember.
Oh.
No, they did.
Smoke a Doke.
Oh.
They have Punch as well. I think Hanskin might
They need to find themselves a Shadow Fiend. Otherwise, the Chikuro will have to do.
Tank the gank, hands gun. Good job tanking the gank. Well played.
I'm going to get this kill with the heal.
Yep.
Yeah.
Easy peasy.
It's okay. I mean, you get it. It costs you a smoke. It's fine. You know, as we said, Empire really want to get ahead in the laning
so
phases.
Going for the buckler, which means that's a pipe? Is that the thing?
No, you don't go.
If it's okay, I mean,
is
call
this...
down.
Is
nah,
it?
It's definitely
no,
not pipe. It's 100% miscommunication.
Yeah.
That's not great.
No. He's gonna punch and blow up.
He just wanted a Requiem, dude.
Empire are playing very well. Yeah. Aloha Dance and Resolution are opening up the map so much.
They are space creating right now, because this is a lot.
Oh, that's a good charge.
They're still fine. Like, Joker's gonna do so much damage.
Yeah, he's gotta be careful here.
No, I think they're fine. There are four people here.
Wow, that Sven is doing so much.
He does nothing. Oh. he's hitting like a kitten.
But they need a Darkseer there for this fight.
But the Sven, dude, he's doing so much.
Shut up.
Kappa.
They needed the Darkseer.
I believe in
them.
You got this.
Oh, Hans
can't anymore.
Get up there, Yoko.
He's dead. Yeah, still got him. No. Well played.
Oh.
Wait.
No.
What is this guy doing?
He's crazy.
He's playing.
He's alone. Crazy.
He dead.
Why are you faster than
16%. I mean 17.
Turn into the...
Is that...
What's up? Okay.
What's happening is, NIP have decided...
I think it's just...
They need to rotate the Darkseer when they fight.
Exactly.
Yeah. He needs to Iron Shield the Sven, and Sven warcries and runs at them and does a load of Iron Shield.
Imagine
damage.
That fight top in the jungle. If your Darkseer was there with a vacuum wall, you would just destroy him.
And Iron Shields. And so just...
Well, it's just the interruption. You know, you could potentially... the ultimate coming out from Spirit Breaker, I can't remember the name of it now.
Nether Strike.
Yeah. You know, with a vacuum. So, you know, that keeps your Shadow Fiend alive. And then what? They got a buckler on their SF.
Was his TP up at the time, though? Is that the question?
Maybe.
Who knows?
This.
And these items, man. But
Salt Bag for Soul Ring? Okay. Yeah. I don't know. This is miscommunication with the.
And this fan is going to take. A while to come online now, and the gyro and the TA are definitely going to be outputting so much more damage.
Like they need Vlads.
The problem is if
Eric does nothing.
If you miss your timing right now, in terms of I have to hold that thought.
He'd be dead.
But if you miss your timing on like fighting with the Ion Shell and the Vacuum and the Surge before BKBs are actually out, and then the TA and the gyro both have BKBs. Your Sven actually does nothing.
Yeah.
Like, he actually will do zero in fights.
I think Sven, right now, just needs to focus on actually just getting damage items. Like, don't go the Blink build. Just rely on your Darkseer to be able to get the initiation.
Yeah.
And just run in and be like, I need to hit somebody and then I want to hit. You know, whether it be an armlet, whether it be drums, whether it be going into a Chrysalis. I just don't think you can play Sven in Era's position with a Blink. Versus this lineup.
Oh no, definitely not.
I think you'll be so far behind.
The problem
on
is
damage output.
You also need chase as well because they're so fast with the even with the Spirit Breaker passive.
I think Empire will be taking the fights to Nip now, and it's all about reacting.
I still don't think Blink is that bad. If you can get the vacuum into Stormhammer, you can defend high ground really well with that.
Yeah, but defending high ground means you give them all the outer towers, right?
Well, it's kind of looking like that already.
Yeah.
You know, I'm just thinking.
No, I think Nip did kind of what Alliance did in the game one, right? They had a good plan, and then the execution.
I never liked the Sven. That was the only thing about their lineup that I didn't agree with, the Sven. But everything else I thought was good.
I think it works if you do rotate the Darkseer to assist them.
That's a really weird way to play it, right? Because how many teams rotate their offlaner a
lot about it,
when it's Darkseer, you know?
I just don't think they should have been in that's where they should have needed to have to rotate the Darkseer. I felt that the top lane fights weren't played well.
By
the Witch Doctor.
That's true.
So I think if you sustained your Sven, they wouldn't have this impact on their Tusk and Spirit Breaker. But they've earned it. Empire have earned their advantage. And basically, this TA and is just going to create such a mid-game nuisance in terms of damage. And the gyro is just going to follow up. I mean, they're not going to slow down. So it's a game of keeping your cores alive versus a menacing team that can roam, as well as trying to outfarm them. If you lose map control, you're going to be even further behind in this 12-3 scoreline where Empire have certainly taken charge.
Nobody's even addressed the gyrocopter from Ninjas and Gemmas yet.
They can't. There's no space for it. They're just getting ran.
They need to turn these fights in their favor. Like anytime the next time the Spirit Breaker and Tusk come in, they need to turn these fights, and they can.
That was just like this fight punch.
Oh, they're gonna go in.
Oh, I knocked them
all. He bashed them all.
But he's stuck.
He's still getting.
Then
and now that fight is untakeable unless you have your Darkseer. He's gone the blink.
It was weird as well because like Hanscan dying again.
Okay, yes.
Yeah, Hanscan died in the middle lane, and then they
they're all dead.
Yeah.
I can see what Nip were going for though. I think that the potential for the Darkseer Sven was there.
Yeah.
I just never really thought that it would get past the laning phase.
I think it's still there.
Look at Spirit Break and he's charging middle. It's just like...
The pressure.
Yeah, it's just like going for kills all over the map at all times.
Yeah, because that's so far ahead. Yeah,
can he solo kill Limp actually?
Nether Strike is still up.
Yeah, if
he's getting so greedy though because of how low Limp is.
There we go, finally.
Oh, he gets a turn around.
One defense.
Yep.
It
was weird though, because like Hanscan earlier died in the middle, right? And it was obvious they were gonna go up and contest Limp in the jungle and the stacks.
Yeah.
Then that's when the big fight in the jungle happened, right? And then like I think Nip should have seen like that coming, and they didn't react with either Darkseer or they didn't react in time with like more people.
All right, so I'm gonna go for a bold statement here. NIP is still gonna win.
Okay. Yeah, I agree.
I mean, they can take it late.
They can definitely win. They have the combo that can turn around an entire team fight together.
If they actually start turning up with their teams to defend, as I predicted, they should take win after win after win.
Now they get a lot of
they cut Aero out of the fight.
But they have the armor on now.
He's melting the ice.
Oh, cooldown only hits two, I guess.
Limp still has ulti.
Requiem, does he have mech up?
He has Aegis on TA as well. They're kind of overcommitting for it. Oh my god, he's so tanky!
Oh my god. Oh, the blink. He can't go through
the
wall. He's
gonna break it. Yeah.
Hera, please!
Nice shot.
Oh, that was pretty close actually.
When they blocked Hera out with the.
Yeah,
the
that was
shots.
Dude, did you kill him? Tried to melt the ice. He's like, I'll help you! Put the fire at it. That didn't work.
Yeah, so Empire gets an even bigger lead.
Damn. Then blink up on TA. You go TA, or you go blink after Desolator, right?
Yeah, blink BKB.
Right. Yeah.
Like at this point, it doesn't need the BKB before blink.
Yeah, definitely not.
I mean, I think BKB would be okay if you just want to walk at towers and hit them.
Yeah. So, like in Empire shoes now, do you try to hit the timing to finish the game, say in like 25-30 minutes?
Look at just controlling the map, take the next tier 2s when you can, and get the next Roche, and by then you should have your BKBs up, which means you should win these outer team fights, even if they 5-man defend over tier 2 towers, and then you just walk up to base and you've got plenty of minus armor on your TA.
Yeah, that's probably the play.
It still is quite hard to take high ground for Empire.
Yep. When the BKBs come online though, the 5-man engagements outside of the base for the tier 2 towers for NIP, it could just end up being an absolute slaughter.
The thing is as well, they have the Dazzle, so they have the sustain plus the weave for breaking.
And the Witch Hunter has nothing. I mean,
they have
level 6.
Yeah.
Look at this.
They've got Guardian Greaves nearly up on Tusk as well if you choose to go for
it. Yeah, he has mech as well. So like they have Urn as well on Spirit Breaker. So they have like the heal and sustain to break high ground, say in like 5 to 10 minutes. If they choose to go that way, right?
Yeah.
They don't necessarily need to. They can like do the out farm, control the map as well.
Alright.
I think.
Yeah, I just feel that the tier 2 fight's a little bit too hard for Empire to take currently.
Mm.
Until they get a BKB up on one of their cores.
Yeah.
Which will be TA probably first, I would hope.
They won a game.
They smoked under a ward. Yeah.
This is a good time to take a fight. I completely agree with what NIP are doing. I even think it's fine to go on the gyro. He's way out of position.
Oh, go here!
Oh my.
The charge.
He didn't initiate.
No, Limp. Don't stand. Oh my god, he instantly died.
That's actually a really good fight for NIP, isn't it?
Yeah.
But is it enough?
They've already lost
two. Get in there, fight.
Oh my god,
the damage.
Even with the...
DD. Like,
on a Desolator, it's actually...
What's
this? Oh god! So much damage from Yoku! What a beast!
Jesus. Jonas, some fan, kind of misplayed there. The illusions did nothing after they spawned as well. They was just standing there, they didn't hit anyone.
Did they not have an ice path on the vacuum?
No. He used it, but I don't think it hit the vacuum.
Okay.
It looked good in the start with the limp, Requiem, the vacuum, wall.
Yeah, yeah, picking up the gyro was nice.
The problem is, you don't really get too many more of those types of fights.
Yeah. No, they really don't. That's like, they might not even get another one where they have a chance to do that.
Yeah.
I mean, Roshan, they've got a trap in Rosh Pit, so they've got map control. They're going to see when it comes up. Guardians Greaves, they've got a gem, so they're going to start removing map control. And we can see maybe the next items for TA and Gyro, if we can check those. I would still expect now a BKB go and Gyro.
BKB,
yeah. So you've got probably, I don't know, one fight maybe? How many smokes do they have available in Nip Shop? I guess we have to check the shop. One, got one left, so
that is probably their last.
That's the last chance smoke in my opinion. Yeah.
What's
going on? How's Darkseer looking? Did he?
He got Vlad's.
He went Vlad's. Okay, and he's quite far away from the blink.
Oh, Hansen's dead.
Here we go, gaming boys.
Okay, Aaron might just die as well.
Nice snowball picking everyone takes him away.
Nice one. Or the vacuum missed the wall. Okay.
I think he vacked more to.
To disrupt,
stop them.
Yeah.
Alright, here we go. Level 6 Witch Doctor. Time to stun the play.
Do it, Silken.
Dun, 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 dun.
Okay.
Oh, yes.
Dun, 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 dun.
Interesting.
Dun.
Oh, Sally, get the snowball.
Oh, the grave.
Oh, look at that signal.
He went back, right?
Look at
he has another DD.
That's for Runes, dude.
Oh,
here we go. It's kill. Yes.
Oh, yeah. Worth. Reeves up.
That gold. 942 worth. Gold.
No, he only got half though.
Oh yeah, buyback.
Oh, they actually got something done with their witch doctor.
I mean, yeah.
Yeah?
I mean, that's pretty good.
Still though, five people died on a buyback.
Yeah, I know, but I mean, considering that snowball completely negated the wall.
Yeah.
It went pretty okay.
Yeah.
If it wasn't for another DD, and you know, it could have gone a lot better. And also Limp, you know, unfortunately, he was the kind of saving grace in that team fight, just being in a good position, being able to hit some initial raises when the second part of the fight went on. But the DD again, you know, it's a killer. And when you've just got a Sven running around with no supports helping him, it does feel pretty useless at this stage of the game.
Oh, you're some fun.
I think another thing too is. During the fights, the snowball seems to be so useful against the wall because you can get everyone out of the wall pretty much immediately. You relocate the fight, so sometimes you have a really hard time like moving around.
What?
He blinks.
Okay.
He knows his surge and stuff, so it's pretty hard for him to get that kind of damage out that quickly.
What
there we have BKB.
Yeah. This game is like so hard for Nip.
It's very. What levels did he have?
Roshan in the levels less than 2 minutes.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, pretty big.
The Dazzle was so strong as well, like position wise.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Like Dazzle was having no problems in these team fights.
Oh, save Hans.
But they have no like gap closers. The only one is Sven.
Can we check Dazzle's items by the way, as he's repaused, just to see? Yeah, just a casual bracer and also treads. Like it's very hard to
actually
want to actually jump on that as Era and chase. Because it's not going to equate to anything.
At the very best, you bait out a grave, and that's
it. Yeah, mm-hmm. and then you've lost your team fight already as well. So this Dazzle is very problematic. And you know, in credit to the Spirit Broker and Tusk, you don't get to fight the Dazzle when you've got those two heroes.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, they've been the ones initiating, so like finding and jumping the Dazzle is kind of hard.
All right,
cool, sir.
Dazzle's back in the game.
Maybe his cat keeps standing on the off button on his computer.
My cat actually did that once or twice.
Yeah. It's a serious problem.
Yep.
Oh, they're gonna snowball.
Oh, Hans, gonna do something? The weave on him.
Ooh, something.
Oh, right, so, kid. Oh, here's that dude.
After having seen the way this played out, I actually think Witch Doctor is horrible against Tusk.
Yeah.
I thought on paper it might be pretty good. But it relies you on getting the cask after the snowball has already been
used.
Which
they don't use, so they just...
It's just very unreliable.
22 minutes.
Yeah. Good spend, though.
Huh? Shut up. Are you flaming me?
Yeah, flaming Shane. It's just...
It's not as if I picked it.
You were like, they're going to pick Sven. And then they picked it, and they lost.
Yeah.
So as team captain, Shane, what is your plan for next game?
Maybe have more communication about when we're fighting. Like, it seemed like Jonas in the offlane just kind of sat there when they were just fighting in the jungle. He didn't even TP react at all. So maybe try and be on the offensive more with air supports instead of